In this video, we're going to continue our discussion on the psychoanalytic theory of personality by going over the levels of awareness. Freud believed that we had three levels of awareness: the conscious, preconscious, and unconscious. And remember, he also believed that the structure of our personality has three components: the id, the ego, and the superego. The way that the structure of our personality relates to the levels of awareness is often represented using this iceberg diagram. You can see here, at the surface, you have the conscious, then a bit deeper, you have the preconscious, and very deep, you have the unconscious. You can also see where the different components of personality live in these different levels. So you can see that the ego and the superego can be found at all three levels of awareness, but the id is strictly in the unconscious. All right, so now let's look at each level more closely. First, the conscious. These are our mental contents, our thoughts, our feelings, and perceptions that we are aware of at a particular moment in time. So as an example, this could be this lesson that you're paying attention to right now, or you're starting to get a bit hungry, right? This is our awareness. And this includes our ego and superego. Next, we have the preconscious. These are the mental contents just beneath awareness, but they can be readily retrieved and brought to our awareness. A very good example is, what did you have for lunch yesterday? It's not something that's consciously in your awareness, but you can easily retrieve those memories and bring it to your awareness. And again, this is our ego and superego. Finally, we have our unconscious. As we've mentioned multiple times, we know the unconscious is very important to Freud in determining our behavior. The unconscious are our memories, emotional conflicts, thoughts, and desires that are not directly accessible, but greatly influence behavior. An example would be childhood trauma. Freud thought that these kinds of memories or emotional conflicts, they're in our unconscious, but they still greatly determine our behaviors. And because of the importance of the unconscious, Freud's technique of using psychoanalysis to treat patients often was trying to get information about the unconscious. If you look at the way that the unconscious is described, it's not directly accessible, but that doesn't mean that it's impossible to access. In fact, some of the techniques of psychoanalysis, such as dream analysis or Freudian slips, were designed to try to get information about the unconscious. And again, the unconscious has the ego, superego, and the id. And those are the different levels of awareness.
If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and clicking the bell icon for notifications. We release new videos every week covering the highest yield content on the MCAT. Plus, you can check out the video description for links to useful resources like our MCAT Prep mobile application.